Now, I have two nephews. Here's the obligatory slide. There's the obligatory slide. Alexander and Andrew were born in 2001 and 2002. When Alex was about 18 months old, he was watching his mom mousing around with a laptop, and he started to imitate her doing that. Pretty soon he was doing it quite well. His younger brother watched his older brother mousing around with a laptop, started to imitate it, and pretty soon they were both so good at it, they were fighting for control of the mouse. Children are experts in mimesis, that is, a learning by imitation. And here's the thing, they did a test last year which showed when you compared young chimpanzees and toddler human beings, the chimpanzees outperformed the toddlers in cognitive tasks, but the toddlers well outperformed the chimpanzees in their ability to ape behavior. We are built to observe and replicate the behavior of our teachers, of our parents, of our peers. And our peers now number 3.5 billion. So the new rule is that whenever any one of us displays a new behavior in a hyperconnected context, that behavior is now inherently visible, it's observed, it's copied. If the behavior is successful, it's immediately copied by someone who observes that behavior, and it's then immediately copied by someone who observed that behavior, and so on and so on. So very quickly, successful behaviors get incorporated into a new global behavioral kit. And so, as its first order of quality, all of this hyperconnection is producing a new thing, hypermimesis, which is the absolutely unprecedented acceleration of the normal processes of observational learning that we're all wired for until they become global and nearly instantaneous. Now, a decade ago, all of this hardware, all of this network was all very raw technology, but we're learning fast, and we're learning globally, and we're all sharing it. So behaviors that were copied slowly from generation to generation, and then copied still slowly from location to location, are hyper-distributed globally and instantaneously. We are all learning from each other with every text we send, and every successful behavior becomes part of the kit of a new civilization. Now, we do not know much about the form of this new culture, even as it pops out of the ether all around us. We know that it is fluid and flexible and mobile and pervasive and inexorable. We know that it does not allow for the new proprieties of privacy and secrecy and ownership, and those define the fundamental ground of the liberal civilization. We know that even as it grows, it is encountering increasingly stiff opposition from conservative forces which are intent on moderating its impact. But every assault, every tariff, and every law that has been designed to constrain the human network has failed. Consider. The Chinese, who gave it a very fair go, have conceded the failure of their great firewall of China and now rely on self-censorship, situating the secret policeman in the mind of the dissident netizen. Record companies, movie companies, try to block the distribution of channels they cannot control or tariff. Every attempt to control the distribution results in an ever more pervasive and ever more difficult to detect darknet. And the band of reporters and bloggers, and I hope some of them are in the room today, took down the Attorney General of the United States of America, despite to obfuscate and then overload the processes of oversight and transparency. Any one of those singular examples would have been completely unthinkable a decade ago. They're the facts on the ground now, and they are the unmistakable signs of the potency of this new cultural order. It's as if we've all been shoved into the same room, basically a postmodern panopticon, and everyone can watch everyone else, learn from everyone else, can speak with everyone else, and basically can talk to everyone else. So we can send out a call to find the others.